It's a known fact that the earlier a child begins to develop mentally through proper institutional learning, the better chance the child will succeed in school. The concept has been totally adapted in the Jersey City School District by the Early Childhood Department, led by Dr. Patricia Bryant. This year commemorates 25 years preparing young minds for the entree in starting school. In honor of Dr. Bryant and the work of her highly successful department, Mayor Steve Fulop in his office, along with Superintendent Dr. Lyles, acknowledged the early childhood staff with a ceremony at City Hall.
Today is the week that the National Association for the Education of Young Children puts aside so that all over the country and actually the world, that young children and their teachers and their parents are recognized. This year it's especially fantastic because this is the 25th year of pre-K in Jersey City. We started in 1989 with 15 classes, a little over 150 students, and today we have over 4,500 students in preschool here in Jersey City. The best thing that has happened is just to see the program grow. There's been so much research that talks about giving children, young children, high-quality preschool experiences, and the growth and gains that they make at the end in terms of more employment, being able to buy houses, going on to college, doing better in their test scores. So we're extremely happy to see how this program has grown over time. One of the best things that symbolizes today is just to see the young children all over the city celebrating this week. We have celebrations here at City Hall. We also have one happening at PS 15 school and PS number 6. So we have this celebration happening over three areas of the city so that more children and families and teachers can join in this process, as well as the child care centers and Head Start. They are also involved in celebrating this week. You know, I'm reminded about a billboard that I just saw just the other day. I was driving down Old Bourbon Road in Merritt, you know, where the bus depot is down there. And I looked up and I saw a picture of Kermit the Frog. Now, of course, being early childhood, I thought, oh, wow, Kermit! And then I read the message, which said something like this: eats frogs, dates a pig, is a Hollywood star, dare to dream. That made me chuckle. I mean, think about it. A frog, a Hollywood star, who would have thought? Well, just like Kermit, we have to channel ourselves to be the best we can be. Are we all going to make it to Hollywood? I'm not sure, but we can all be the best we can be, absolutely. So today, let's all take time to look at the person in the mirror. We're trying to figure out life. Before we take our good energy to criticize, point fingers at others, and or complain, let's commit to first take some time to do some self-reflecting. As President Obama has stated, we are the change that we seek. So if you want to make the world a better place, take a look at yourself and then make a change. And it's always a pleasure to enter this facility that bears his name at this time of the month yearly to recognize those in the community who have given so much of themselves to enhance the lives of others, especially since Mayor Cunningham was such an historian. And just what is history? History for me are stories of the past. So to come to the Cunningham Center to celebrate Black History Month and recognize the contributions made by members of the community in the context of children and families, since we all know, is so fitting because we all know children love stories. Now, what stories do we tell our children about their legacy? Margaret Burroughs gives us some insight into this dilemma through her poem entitled, What Shall I Tell My Children Who Are Black? I just want to share a few pieces of that. What shall I tell my children who are black of what it means to be captive in dark skin? What shall I tell my dear one, fruit of my womb, of how beautiful they are, when everywhere they turn, they are faced with the aberrance of everything that is black. The night is black, and so is the boogeyman. Villains are black with black hearts. The black cow gives no milk. A black hen lays no eggs. Storm clouds black, black is evil, evil is black, and devil's food is black. What shall I tell my dear ones raised in a white world, a place where white has been made to represent all that is good and pure and fine and decent, where clouds are white and dolls and heaven surely is white, white place with angels robed in white and cotton candy and ice cream and milk and ruffled Sunday dresses and dream houses and long sleek Cadillacs and angels' food is white, all white. What can I say, therefore, when my child comes home in tears because a playmate has called him black, big lip, flat nose, and nappy headed? What will he think when I dry his tears and whisper, yes, that's true, but no less beautiful and dear? How shall I lift up his head, get him to square shoulders, look at his adversaries in the eye, confident in the knowledge of his worth, serene under his sable skin and proud of his own beauty? What can I do to give him strength that he may come through life adversities as a whole human being? He must survive, for who knows? Perhaps this black child here bears the genius to discover the cure for cancer or to chart the course for exploration of the universe. Look at these children. Look at their dreams. So he must survive for the good of all humanity. And I find I have much to say about my black children. I will lift their heads in proud blackness with the story of their fathers and their fathers' fathers. And I shall take him into time of when kings and queens ruled the Nile and measured the stars, discovered the laws of mathematics. I will tell them of a black people upon whose backs have been built the wealth of three continents. I will tell him about Franklin Walker, Jeffrey Dublin, Michael Wins, Bobby Stewart, Virginia Miller, and the late Rudy Snelling. I will tell them this and more. Knowledge of their heritage shall be the weapon and their armor. It will make them strong enough to win any battle they may face. And since this story is so often obscured, I must sacrifice to find it for my children, even as I sacrifice to feed them, clothe them, and shelter them. See, the story is real important. So this I will do for them if I love them, because no one will do it for me. So there's no doubt in my mind that the sponsors of this event do this because of their love for our children and the community. Therefore, on behalf of the Early Childhood Department, I would like to thank Senator Bowles and Cunningham, Ms. West, and the 8th Annual Black History Month Celebration Committee for the sacrifices that you make and continue to make to make this happen every single year so that the stories of our community leaders are heard.
Well, I don't even really have words to express how I'm feeling right now. I am just so honored and so touched and feel so blessed to just see everyone here today and to hear the words that I've heard today and to know that people can keep a secret in this district. And I was very committed to teaching at a very, very young age. And even growing up, I would write stories and I would read them in the summer to the children who lived in the Arlington Gardens. It was just around the corner from my house. And I remember even in the summer working at St. Pat's teaching. And so I always knew that that's really what was in my blood to do. So when I heard the children today singing, you know, I have a dream. You know, dreams are real important. And when I was in 39 school, that was one of the things that we worked on, is giving children the ability to dream, because if you can't see it, you can't reach it. So you really need to be able to see it because then you have a goal in mind and you have some place to go to. So those are the greatest honors, when you see the children and they come back to say, Miss Bryant, but the teachers, they say, you've had an influence on my life.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying how do you do. They're really saying I love you. I hear babies cry, I watch them grow. They're like much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying how do you do. They're really saying I love you. I hear babies cry, I watch them grow. They're like much more than I never knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
In this world, extraordinary people. I'm glad there is you. In this world of overrated pleasures and underrated treasures, I'm so glad